We hear the word pollution almost every day through the news, commercials, and even entertainment. While there's a lot of focus on global pollution, there's other types of pollution that can affect us personally. The air inside our homes may be 2 to 5 times more polluted than the outside air. Indoor air pollution can affect your health as well as the appearance and value of your home.
The Alamance County Health Department presents Breathing Easier, all about indoor air quality. Where does indoor air pollution come from?
Well, from you and me. We all create some form of indoor air pollution every day. It may be from using a fireplace or wood stove, smoking cigarettes, air fresheners, cleaning supplies, pesticides, even cooking can release chemicals into your household air. But people aren't the only source of indoor air pollution. There are also natural causes like moisture, mildew, pollen, and mold that can all have major effects on you and your home.
How does indoor air pollution affect me?
Indoor pollution can drastically affect the health of the people that live in your home. Breathing problems such as asthma are greatly affected by indoor pollutants, but even those without asthma can be affected. Respiratory infections, headaches, nervous system disorders, and other diseases can come from air pollutants. Some pollutants are even deadly, especially in situations where someone's immune system or lungs are compromised. Carbon monoxide is another indoor pollutant which can kill. Along with your health, indoor air pollution can affect your home and finances. Moisture damage can cause mold growth in your home, which can cost thousands of dollars to repair.
How can I determine my home's air quality?
The first thing you can do is ask yourself a few basic questions that may help to determine your home's air quality. Do you or others cough and sneeze in your home? Do you or others wake up congested or with a headache? Do you or others often have an irritated throat, nose, or eyes? Do any of these symptoms occur more often in certain parts of your house? Does anyone in your home have frequent asthma episodes or respiratory infections? Finally, do you notice that you feel better when you are away from your home? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you may have an air quality issue.
What can I do to improve my home's air quality?
Whether or not you have a major air quality problem in your home, you can take steps to improve the quality of air in the home. Don't smoke cigarettes indoors. Check and replace air filters every 2 to 3 months with HEPA filters. Vacuum carpets and stuff furniture well. Wash linens weekly and dust regularly to keep allergens and dust mites to a minimum. If you are or think you might be allergic to dust mites, you can use special pillow and mattress covers that are available at local department and retail stores. Circulate fresh air throughout your home every day to get rid of stale air. Try to use cleaning products that do not include the words danger, warning, or caution. Always make sure to follow label instructions of any cleaning product. Use ventilating fans in the kitchen and bathroom to move moisture outside of the house. If you have a fireplace or wood stove, make sure you also have good ventilation in those rooms. If you use natural gas, make sure the flame is mostly blue and not yellow. Don't ever burn charcoal or kerosene heaters indoors. Install carbon monoxide detectors to alert you if you have carbon monoxide in your home.
What about mold and mildew?
There's been a lot in the news about mold causing major problems in homes and businesses. While mold is a natural part of our environment, you can help to reduce the amount of mold in your home by reducing the amount of moisture in your home's air. Change the air in your house at least daily. Several times a day is better. Ventilate the bathroom and kitchen with an exhaust fan. Install a timed switch on your bathroom's fan to let it ventilate for at least 15 minutes after your shower. Keep shower curtains and doors open after showering. Make sure your clothes dryer vents freely to the outside. Repair leaks as quickly as possible and keep water from entering basements and crawl spaces. Properly insulate your walls and ceilings. Keep furniture away from outside walls where mold might grow. If you do find mold, clean it up with regular soap and water. Then apply a chlorine bleach solution of 1 part bleach to 4 parts water to the affected area. The Alamance County Health Department Environmental Health Section will be happy to help you in this process. You can contact Environmental Health for a home assessment of indoor air quality. They will be happy to help you evaluate the air in your home and help you find ways to improve your home and your family's health. For more information about this service, please contact Alamance County Environmental Health at 570-6367. Thank you, stay safe, be healthy, breathe easier.